There are many needs in our community, but also tremendous resources in our not-for-profit organizations and community-based organizations to adequately meet needs and help our children become successful adults. How would you reach out to the many service providers in the village to forge an effective school-community partnership?
One of the things that I talked about earlier was that when the community was at its best, when all of the, when education was a priority, and everyone, all the key players, came together, I think the greater issue has become is that we've become so divisive that what we can do, we don't do. And so we now have to come to the table because everyone's looking out for themselves individually and forgetting about the children. So what we have to do is come to the table, everyone, and say we're not doing this for just one group of people or one sect of people, but we're doing it for the entire community. Because if we create a platform that all of our children can receive the services or the information or the education or the external things that they need to become citizens. We ought to understand this. An intelligent child makes an intelligent adult. A wise child who makes a wise adult. So we've got to make sure that we create posterity in our children so that when they become adults, we won't have the same cycle that we're dealing with now. We won't have systemic behavior, but we will have persons who would have been, who've come up through the ranks, and now they're coming back, such as many of the candidates on this forum are coming back to say, hey, we came through here. We were built through here. We were ingrained through here. And now we're coming back to bring here to where we once were.
We have a lot of great programs in the village of Hempstead, and we can, one of my ways of bringing the groups together is to call a focus group. All the not-for-profit agencies come together and do some collaboration, do some brainstorming and do a needs assessment, and form a partnership with the schools to work. And also inclusive of that with the grants, I'm sure we can apply for many grants under the school and give some of the not-for-profits some of that grant money so they can sustain their programs. Because if you know, there's not a lot of grants or in prevention and intervention. It's all about crisis. And I know it can be done because I've done it before with my program and worked with many agencies. And also include with that a youth forum and a parent forum. And then we will move together, working together, collaboration and partnership.
For one, I'm very happy that one of our nonprofit agencies is bringing this suggestion up. But we've got to figure that out together. It's not a solo act. It has to be collaborated with the churches, the nonprofit agencies that deal with children and their issues. It has to be the Boy Scouts, the Girl Scouts. All of these separate units should all come together now. It can be done. We can meet at the school, we can meet here at the library, but to learn what we can offer to these children, for our children. Let it be known that you're willing to help. And that's the kind of community that's going to build a better educational program for our children. They belong to us because they represent us. Okay, mine are grown, mine are in the 40s. But by the same token, I really feel responsible. This is why we developed a program called the Community Junior Golf Program. I started playing golf when I was 48, but now I'm willing to help the children learn how to play golf. Give them instruction, give them that experience, that educational opportunity, which is filled with scholarships all over the country. So things can be done, but we've got to come together. So Bill, I commend you for your question, and I think that we should just bring everything together. Let's meet, let's start to develop some ideas, and thank you.
I think it's about time we start taking these not-for-profit organizations up on their offer and actually inviting them down to sit down and to talk some ideas on how we can better put our resources all together to assist the students and the residents of Hempstead as a whole. It's good to talk. talk, but we have to be about what we're talking about. So not just the nonprofit organizations, like I said, there's a whole bunch of groups in Hempstead. Everybody has a group. We all just need to come to the same table and put our heads together and see what it is that we can do for the children and actually do just that, assist the children.
This is one of the sad parts about the art district, and as a result of the lack of interest, the lack of participation, the school board has been working so hard to keep the community apart, to keep the community out of the system, that we are losing opportunities. We have hospitals, we have the court, we have universities all around us, but we don't partnership with them. And they don't get close to us, they don't come to us, because they know how we try very hard to keep the community apart. And it's one of our goals, to make form committees that reach out to them, not only for grants, but for opportunities. We need to expose the students, we need to take them to hospitals, we need to let them know all kinds of jobs that they are there. If we open up the doors for the community, for the businesses, and for parents especially, because parents, they've been rejected for the board meetings. And this is the results that we are getting, that we are lacking the opportunities that we should be taking advantage of.
As an entrepreneur, one of my strong suits is developing and maintaining relationships. The table that my brother David Gates just referred to a minute ago is that table that five people sit on, that school board. I believe that there are some good things that can happen there, but I think there's a lot of frustration on that level. And I think that they understand, for the most part, that there does need to be relationships developed with the village, with organizations, with corporations. And I think that once we make the changes that are necessary and we get five like-minded folks sitting at that table who are rational thinking individuals, we can start doing some of these things. I happen to know for a fact that there's things that can be done, and I know that there are people that are sitting at that table who are interested in making these things happen. But for whatever reasons, there's some things that are keeping that from happening. And I know that it's extremely frustrating, not only for the community, but for the people who are sitting there. And I think that if the right things are done on May 20th, that we make those subs that I referred to earlier, and we can get those five people sitting around that table that are like-minded and rational in their thinking, we can start having conversation and develop those relationships, maintain those relationships with the village, with organizations, with major corporations that will definitely benefit all the children of Hempstead.
Thank you. Okay, thank you.